This is a war game in the age of the laser beam. The tank appears to blow up, but doesn't. The crew aren't injured, but the man who fires the fatal shot learns. Such equipment is complex and costly, and Britain leads the world. From an unpretentious factory in Enfield, Westerns design and manufacture battle simulators. Today, there were consignments for armies across the globe, but Britain's defences are suffering spending cuts, and training doesn't come cheap. How likely, Tim Egger, is the average soldier to fire a real live shell as part of his training?
Once or at the outside twice a year.
Is that ridiculous in your opinion?
No, it's a pure factor of the cost now. I mean, to fire an anti-tank weapon, the latest anti-tank weapon, costs £7,000 per shell fired. So you can see there's a monetary restriction on how often they can be used.
Tomorrow, Mr. Egger is raising the matter in Parliament. It's a case that would seem to speak for itself, for the sophisticated computer-linked lasers not only simulate exactly what a real weapon does, but tells the man who fires it what went wrong when he misses. And for reality's sake, the equipment can even trigger off some harmless thunder flashes too. The price, around £20,000 a kit.
Obviously, all other things being equal, it is much better for the army to invest, say, £20,000 in simulation equipment, which can be fired any number of times, as against £7,000 for a live missile.
So within the next month or so, the MOD will have to choose between ordering these London-made life-size Space Invaders kits or giving their gunners a live shell once or twice a year.